Hi everyone, I'm Misty from Adamson Equestrian, and today we're talking about four factors that you need to consider when trying to decide whether or not to blanket your horse. So stick around. Here in the Midwest, we go through a lot of weather changes. One day of the week, it could be 40 degrees and sunny. The next, it can be negative 10 with a wind chill of negative 20. And the next day, it could be 60 with a chance of tornadoes. So I'm being a little bit dramatic, but the whole point of that is you want to be prepared no matter what the weather is to be able to blanket your horse if that's what they need. To blanket or not to blanket? That is the question that we need to answer today. So here are four factors to consider whenever you're trying to decide whether or not your horse needs to be blanketed or not. Factor number one is the coat. In the summertime, your horse's coat is soft and lays flat against their skin. In the wintertime, the hair grows longer and it's fluffier and it kind of fluffs out a little bit to help insulate his body. Horses that have a full winter coat are more equipped to handle colder temperatures versus a horse that's being shown and has a show clip. In that case, when you've clipped off half of their hair on their lower body so that they don't get too hot when you're working them, you need to supplement it with a blanket. If you have a horse that didn't go completely full woolly for the winter, so he's kind of in an in-between stage where he has a winter coat but it's not super full, those are the times where you just want to monitor your horse and kind of see how they're feeling. Depending on how low the temperatures get, he might need a blanket, he might not. So in those cases, you just kind of watch your horse to see if they're getting too cold versus not. Number two, body condition. Is your horse like Tino, that's a super fat little nugget who loves to eat all the time? Or is he more of an older horse that maybe burns more calories from the food that he eats trying to keep himself warm from the inside out? Tino is definitely an easy keeper. He loves to eat. He's younger, so he doesn't necessarily have to spend more energy to warm himself from the inside out like an older horse would. And he's also in better condition than a lot of horses through the winter for people that maybe only ride for fun and they kind of give their horses the whole winter off. Our horses don't get a break. They get ridden all the time. So in the winter time, he's used to being ridden at minimum 3 times a week. Because Tino's an easy keeper, he loves to eat, he stays in condition through the winter time, and he grows a great winter coat. He's less likely to need to be blanketed than, say, a retired horse that is on a complete break. So there's no conditioning, there's no nothing. Also, the one thing that you have to be careful with older horses is that sometimes their teeth maybe aren't in the greatest shape versus a younger horse. So as they're not able to eat as much and take in and consume as many calories that they can then use to heat themselves, you're probably gonna have to supplement that with a blanket. We used to have an older horse in the barn up until recently. He passed away not too long ago, but his name was Captain. And from the time that he was little, he had broken his jaw. So because his teeth didn't meet together very well, he had a harder time taking in calories or eating food. And then as he grew older, he was less and less easily able to eat. So he was dropping his grain more and he wasn't consuming calories that he could then use to heat himself. With horses like that, you have to blanket them. If they're not consuming enough calories that they're able to heat themselves from the inside out, you need to supplement it with a blanket. For a lot of older horses, if you don't blanket them, you may walk out into the field or even into the barn and you'll notice that maybe they've got some frost on their coat. It's because their body's not insulated as well. So you have to give them some kind of extra supplement with the blanket. Is your horse stalled all winter or does he go outside to play most days? Your horse should always have access to shelter even when they're outside, especially in the winter months, because you never know what the weather's gonna do and you want to give them a place where they can shelter. But if you're sending your horse out to play in the winter time, it might be a good idea to get them a turnout blanket. A horse like Tino is probably fine because he doesn't necessarily go outside as much in the winter. Because the weather is so weird in the Midwest, a lot of times when it's gross outside, our ponies will get turned out in the indoor arena, so they have time to get out of their stall and play for a little while. Because Tino spends the majority of his time in the barn in the winter time, whether it's being turned out into the indoor arena for playtime or if he's in his stall, he's probably less likely to need a winter coat versus a horse that gets sent out to the pasture to play all the time or gets kind of turned out for most of the day. The reason for that is A, he's young. B, he's an easy keeper, so he loves to eat. He consumes calories just fine instead of like with a horse that's not able to eat as much. And C, he's in condition, so he's less likely to need a blanket. On super cold days though, sometimes it doesn't matter how well your horse is in shape or how many calories they consume. Sometimes you still do need to supplement with a blanket depending on how cold it gets outside. In those cases, it's always good to have a blanket on standby just in case, because everyone knows the one thing that you need is the one thing that you don't have when you need it. Factor number four, age. Horses are a lot like people in that when we age, we have a harder time with digestion and circulation and so on. So just as with us, we have a harder time with circulation, we get cold, we need extra blankets to keep us warm. Horses are a lot the same. As they age, they might be less likely to be able to regulate their temperature and they might need a little outside help. All in all, it's good horse sense to have a blanket just in case you need it, because you don't want to walk out in the barn one day and find your furry buddy shivering from the cold, literally. I hope this video was helpful in helping you decide whether or not to blanket your horse. I know that me as an equestrian, I've only been in this for a little while, so everything that I learned to be able to share with you guys helps me tremendously. And I know there's probably a lot of other people out there like me that have, or maybe they don't have an equestrian backing system, because I'm lucky enough that I can just ask my family. But for people out there that are like me that, you know, maybe don't have all of the knowledge at their fingertips, I like being able to do videos like this to share what I've learned with you all. So stay tuned. My next video is gonna be talking about the different types of blankets that there are, because there are so many. It's just like shoes, you know, you need paddock boots for this, you need long boots for that, you need insulated boots for this, you need muck boots for that. So it's kind of the same thing. So there's a different type of blanket for every type of situation. So stay tuned for that, and happy riding.